Thank you. Please continue. Tell us about this truth you discovered.
Very well. Bear in mind, however, that the purpose of this conversation is not to impart scholarly knowledge. For such requires that you comprehend the subject matter, which you will not. We will forego the intricacies of our scientific methodology and deal only with the conclusion. The end of our society and our world. We acknowledge, with regret, that your star is in the midst of the same panic-induced cataclysm that befell Denet 3. As such, in order to avoid causing undue distress, we will refrain from explicitly stating how much time you have remaining.
You are entirely too kind. I pray you recount your tale as you see fit.
In the beginning, the universe was but a tiny particle. Then suddenly, this particle began to expand. Having remained entirely in the bounds of your star, the phenomenon may be difficult for your kind to grasp. But this expansion has since continued unabated.
Speculating that the universe could not grow indefinitely, we sought to learn what might occur and made a worrying discovery. The stars will continue to spread apart, as will their finite thermal energies. Eventually, all heavenly bodies will grow cold and freeze. No new stars will be born, and the universe will enter into an eternal ice age.
Of proving that this determination was erroneous, we scrutinized our research from all angles, even as we sought to avert the everlasting winter. The endeavor proved fruitless, so infamously so, in fact, that it became synonymous with vain effort. The universe as we know it would end, and there is no way to prevent it.
Beneath the weight of this knowledge, our society stagnated. Though we had time still, it was a cold comfort. Why strive for anything when desolation is assured? When our wealth of wisdom, accumulated since the dawning of our kind, would be forever lost. No civilization would rise from our ashes. No scholar recover our knowledge. In silence unbroken, naught would stir.
Intellect was once our pride. Overnight, it became our shame. Our works, monuments to futility. Immortality, our greatest invention, became a source of suffering. Rather than suffer on, many chose to unmake themselves by means of etheric exsanguinators. Etched upon these stones are the testaments of such souls. Though many left no words at all, thinking it a pointless gesture.
Once we have obtained vessels of flesh, we likewise intend to vanish.
If you understand this, understand aught of our tale, you will abandon your quest for knowledge. Ignorance truly is bliss. If you would cling to your illusory happiness, remain primitive and pure. It is the only way.
So that's your story. While I appreciate your advice, I will not heed it. Convinced though you may be of this truth, it is yours and not mine. Indeed, truth, I have ever believed, is in the eye of the beholder.
Are you suggesting that we have reached a faulty conclusion? That our science failed us?
Hardly. As you yourself said, the subject matter is beyond my comprehension. And that, I accept, is true. I do not possess the knowledge to prove or disprove your conclusion. In my mortal years, I doubt I could even approach the wisdom of the Aya. But of one thing am I absolutely certain. I would not be happier in ignorance.
You stole a gnome! You mustn't!
The most important lesson I've learned is that learning isn't simply passing one's eyes over words. Nay, it is when understood for oneself that knowledge attains its true value. This is what has sustained me, driven me onward in joy and wonder, in anger and sorrow. The universe may end, and all may be for naught, but I will live as I always have. I will always seek out new knowledge, and no conclusion of yours, no matter how grim, can dampen my desire.
I suppose it is only to be expected. Their feeble minds cannot fathom the terrifying gravity of it all.
But worry not. We consider it our duty to enlighten you. And we will not stop until you grasp the full extent of our despair.
Keep calm and listen well. Though my body will soon dissipate, there may be a way to restore it. Asim's magic. So long as our souls remain, you can use it to summon us back. But you mustn't, for it would mean losing our way forward. This I only reveal so that you can promise not to invoke the magic. We came here knowing what victory may cost, so press on. Press on. And do not look back.
I shall join thee. As subterfuge is not required, thou shalt not suffer for mine absence.
Urianger.
My resolve hath never been as strong as thine. Full oft have I wavered in my decisions, and afterwards been stricken with regret. In spite of this, I may still stand with my comrades, supporting them as they attempt the greatest of feats. This truth I have learned in the course of our journey. And many though my shortcomings may be, I may also claim to excel in prophecies. My studies, into which have granted me the flexibility of mind needed to bend this malleable reality. Thus shall I hope that thou mayest have the strength to resist, and our comrades the strength to continue.
With you to urge us on, how could we possibly fail?
What's this? An extinguished civilization. Rekindled.
That's right. Our quest doesn't end here. We'll press on, and we will find you.
There. That's where you'll find me.
Is that another star?
Of the stars we visited, most were already devoid of life. And where there was life still, the inhabitants wished for death. But even death, we learned, isn't truly the end. It is but a part of the cycle of rebirth. Souls return to the star, or in its absence, a larger flow. And eventually they are reborn. Alive again, to know suffering anew. True salvation lies not in dying. It lies in not being born. This is the gift I would give to you, to all life on beautiful Atheris. To that end, we created an egg wherein life cannot quicken. That dead sun. Attain it if you can. Before your friends' emotions fade away, along with their protection.